cuties! Billie Jean here from SweetAndTastyTV.com. Are your nails ready for the weekend? Oh, they already are? Well then, let's make them super ready. Due to popular demand, we're G-Dragifying our nails this week. Get your crayons and let's get our cray on! Why so serious? Come on, boy! Come on, girl! Crayon, crayon! Step 1. V-shaped nails. Crayons aren't crayons without their pointed tip. I'm cutting my long, round nails into V-shaped nails. To learn how to make V-shaped nails in detail, watch my first nail tutorial, the one inspired by 21's I Love You music video. The nail clipper has a slight curve, so when you cut your nails, they will have a curve to them. Crayons have straight lines. Take your nail filer and make your curve straight. Remember to smooth your tips a little bit. I found it helpful to set my hand firm on the table and file my nails in a straight motion. If your hand motion is curvy, then your nail lines will become curvy. See the difference between the right and left thumb? It might seem subtle right now, but once we paint on our colored polish, the differences will become more visible. Step 2. Base coat. Wash your hands and make sure there are no oils or nail particles on your nails. We then paint on our base coat. I'm using Essie's Protein Base Coat. Step 3. White polish. Paint on a layer of white polish. This will brighten up the colors when we apply the next layers. As usual, I'm using OPI's Alpine Snow. Step 4. Rainbow time. If we go by the order of the rainbow, the colors will be red, orange, yellow, green, and blue. But I'm switching the colors around to create contrast between the warm and cool tones. Once you assign the colors to each nail, it's time to paint. For red, I'm using OPI's French Bordeaux. For yellow, I'm using OPI's Need Sunglasses. For green, I'm using It's Totally Karma. For orange, I'm using Hot and Spicy. And last but not least, for blue, I'm using No Room for the Blues. Step 5. Another coat of rainbow, if needed. Most of my nails are looking pretty solid, except for the thumbs and a couple accidental dents. So add a second layer of polish on the nails you think need some help. Step 6. Let's get our cray on. It's time to draw the crayons. After your nails are completely dry, get your nail art pen. I'm using Sally Hansen's black nail art pen. Another option is using a toothpick. Draw a horizontal line from one end of your V-shaped nail to the other. Then draw another line right below it. Fill in the space. Create another thick line on the bottom portion of your nail. In the rectangular space right in the middle, draw a wide oval. I'm writing crayon on my nails, so if you're drawing on your middle nail, write an A. Then outline your nail. Take your time and try to make your line a consistent thickness. Now, repeat step 6 9 more times. Yeah, I made my crayons. Step 7. Top coat. Once your beautiful work is dry, apply a top coat. I'm using Sesh Feet's Dry Fast Top Coat. The lady at the store recommended it to me and said it dries within 30 seconds. Let's put her advice to the test, shall we? Okay, it's been a minute. Let's see if our nails are dry. Nope. I'm going to watch a couple K-pop music videos while my top coat dries. I think I'll watch G-Dragon's That XX. Wow, my gosh, my nails are dry. Now, let's make good use of our crayon nails and color the whole wide world. Hehe. What's my secret? I'm hiding a pencil. Shh, don't tell anyone. If you'd like to make a request, post your comments below. Have yourselves a colorful weekend. 안녕!
Each piece is a cylinder, and they have waves on the outside. Stick them in our fingers. Like this.